What's going on, guys? My name is Ben, if you didn't already know me, and today I'm going to be showing you how to unban your console. Well, that's through either a KV, either a modded console, RGH, JTAG, whatever you like to call it. So how do you know if you've been banned, and how do you know if you need a new KV? Okay, pretty much this, guys. When you come onto your modded console, RGH, or JTAG, etc., and you try and sign in as so, it will say this error message: this console has been banned for violations of the service agreements to protect the Xbox Live service and its members. Microsoft does not provide details about console bans. So that's how you sort of know that your console has been banned. And how to get around this, how to get back online, how to unban your actual console, you need to buy a new KV. As I'm going to show you a step-by-step guide on how to change your KV. So guys, next step is to head over to your PC and get a new KV. So I'm going to head over to my PC right now, and I'll see you back in a minute, guys. Alright guys, okay, once you're over onto your PC, you need a few things. First thing is you need Xbox File Manager, so Xbox 360 Neighborhood. That is one program you need to transfer your KV over. You don't have to use Neighborhood. I just use it because it's probably one of the fastest ways of doing it from your computer. You can also do it by USB, but I'm going to be showing you by Neighborhood. If you're going to be using a USB, just follow the same steps, but just using XEX menu. Okay, guys. So, buying a KV. Where can you buy a KV from? So, you can buy KVs from many different sites. You'll probably be able to find them on forums like Seven Sins. For tech games and things like that. I'm going to give you a site that I recommend using, that I trust, and it's normally quite good prices. Their prices do go up and down, but pretty much usually they're quite the lowest prices around, and very reliable KVs, always private KVs. So this site is called unsharedkvs.com. When you go to this site, it will take you and redirect you to another site which is called ejunkie.com. Don't worry, it is totally safe. They don't have their sort of own site. It sort of redirects you to this site because it's the fastest way of getting your KVs, which I'll show you now how to do it. Okay, guys. So when you're on this place, just search for and select what country or region you're from. Doesn't really matter. Just enter a postcode and whatever. And we're just gonna go. It's just trying to calculate your shipping cost, but the shipping cost is nothing anyway. And this is $450 or it's about £3.75 or something like that. I'm not 100% sure. And you just want to check out with PayPal. Once you do check out with PayPal, see you back once I've paid for it. Okay, guys. Once you've actually paid for it, what you want to do, you want to do click on complete purchase, and it should redirect you back to their site again. If it doesn't redirect you, just click here, and it will take you back there for you. Okay, so once it takes you back to their website, you're actually going to get a email. As it says here, if you require any information, it's going to be sent to your email. Sometimes spam filter blocks automatic email, so make sure you check your spam folder or junk mail. If there's any other problems or issues, just contact ionic9898 at hotmail.com for any questions. It also gives you an invoice number, so if you have any problems or anything, just make sure you send that with your question, and I can get back to you straight away. So anyway, guys, so what you want to do, you want to head over to your email, and there should be an email which I'm going to show you once I get there. Okay, guys, once you're back on your emails, you should have two emails, one sort of an invoice and one actually says, Dear Benjamin, which is my name, your code for unshared serials, and it gives you a drive, a Google Drive email download link. Thanks for purchasing. If you need bulk or become a seller to get cheaper KVs and prices, you can contact me. So you can become a seller and get more cheaper prices, and if you want bulk, you might be able to get deals if you contact him directly. But what we're interested in is the drive Google link, so we're going to click on that. Once you click on that, it'll come up there, which is going to be your KV. If you up the top right hand corner, you see downloads, like sort of a down arrow symbol, which you click, and it'll come up as a WinRAR folder for you to download. So we're going to download that. Okay, guys, so that is all going to be finished. So we're going to drag that to the desktop, and we're going to open it up when it wants to just quickly transfer it to the desktop. There you go. We're going to open it up, and we're just going to drag that to the desktop as well. I'm unorganized on my desktop normally, so doesn't really bother me. So we're going to open that up in one window side. We're going to minimize the internet and we're going to drag the Xbox 360 neighborhood over to the other side. Okay, guys, so now this is where you sort of come back to your Xbox. If you're going to use it by USB, you're going to go into XEX menu, and then you're going to go into USB where you've dragged over your CPU key and CV.bin. You're going to drag these two into a USB device, and you're going to plug it into your Xbox, and you're going to go to XEX menu, and you're going to transfer them straight over to the hard drive. If you're going to be doing it by Xbox 360 neighborhood like so, you want to go and sign into your JTAG and or RGH, then go into your hard drive as so, and you probably will see this. If you don't see it, it's okay, just drag it straight in there. But we're going to be replacing the CPU.bin and this KV.bin. So all we're going to do is just highlight the two that we just brought and just drag it straight over onto the console. It says the folder already contains a file name KV.bin, and it's going to say there's going to be one that says CPU.key. We're just going to say yes to all, but so all of them transfer all the way across. We'll just do that again just to make sure that it's all across, like so. So once you've done that, you can exit out of these two if you want to, and I'll head over to the Xbox and show you. Okay guys, we're over on the Xbox right now. So pretty much what we want to do is we're going to turn off the console and we're going to boot it back up. So I'll see you in a minute, guys. Okay guys, so the console is just rebooting right now. I don't know if you've probably been able to see it probably in the video. It actually booted up and then it rebooted itself. That is just sort of the KV sort of regenerating itself, making all the folders that it needs up to date. Once you come on, as you can see, it says welcome Geckomods. My stealth server is continuing, and you've just started a new day on my stealth server. And just to show you that your console has been unbanned, I'm just going to sign in to sub to Geckomods. It'll probably say my account is banned, so I'll probably have to go and make a new one up. But because my stealth server has recognized me and started a new day, it means my console is unbanned. As you can see, it says you'll need a Microsoft account password. I'm not going to fill that in because I already know that his account's probably going to be banned anyway. But because of, let's just show you this way as well. But because of my stealth server has recognized me and it's come online, it means my console is unbanned. Also, another way is going into network settings, going onto your network, and then clicking on test Xbox Live connection, and just letting that run. If there was any problems with my console being banned, when it goes connects from the internet to Xbox Live, it'll be an actual say this console has been banned, the same error that we got trying to sign in. So network was connected, just waiting for the internet to be connected as well. There you go, it's connected, and now trying to go from the internet to Xbox Live, which is also connected. There you go, guys. So it says the servers, Xbox stores, accounts, and matchmaking is all up, so we're all good to go. If you've got any problems, guys, make sure you leave a comment down below, and I'll try and get around to helping you out as much as I can. Also, if you can't contact me through the comments, I always try and be active on my YouTube to get back to you guys. But if not, just message me on Skype. It's TSPXNX. I'm always on there. So just drop me a message and I'll try and help you out as much as I can. Anyway, guys, my name's Ben. Hope this video helped you out. If it has, make sure you leave a like. It'll mean so much to me. But I'll see you in the next video, guys. Thank you guys for watching, and hopefully I helped you out a little bit. If you guys are interested in some of the past sort of videos that I've done, I'll leave two links on the screen now for you. But there'll be definitely more content coming up for you guys, tutorial, gameplays, and more. So anyway guys, if you liked this video and you could leave a like and maybe a comment, it would mean the world to me. And anyway guys, I'll see you in the next video. Stress, I waking up, it's time to get it. Ain't no room for the haters, ain't got time for jealousy. I'm too focused on the music, the money, and where I'm headed. If it rain, I'm a parade, I'ma get an umbrella.